the easiest way of describing what we do in the research collections is we document the species and their distribution. And so this collection of reptiles and amphibians is one of the largest in the world. It's about 300,000 specimens. My name is Darrel Frost. I'm a curator in the Department of Herpetology. People in pre-literate societies have enormous memories. People would recite the Iliad and they would go on for days at a time. Bump, 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 bump. And they could remember it. Our brain is organized in a way that we can handle a lot of structured knowledge. It's because you can store it. And that's why we have taxonomy, so we can organize the world around us. And the collections actually are organized in that way as well. The turtles are all here together. They're not arranged chronologically. They're arranged by what they're related to. So since you have other kinds of structured knowledge in your head as you're looking at them, the structure of the collections themselves actually helps in the formulation of questions. I think that scientists look at these collections differently than most people. Most of us who are actually in science have been around these things since we were in high school in some cases. So we're used to them. The wonder part of it isn't so much in the objects anymore as in the relationships and what they tell us in a sophisticated way. You know, it's kind of like a clarinet. When you think about how it's put together and how it works, that's pretty wondrous. But it's not as wondrous as the music that comes out of it. And so that's the thing about collections. At first blush, it's pretty wonderful stuff, but what it tells you is even better. It documents life on Earth and human cultures. And it documents it in a way that's this ever-increasing effluence of information coming out of this set of objects. In 1880, they weren't thinking about DNA. So the questions change. Collections tell you about the past. But knowing about the past, learning about how things are structured and how they work, you can predict what the future is going to bring.